As of March 13th, 2022, there are 50 volcanoes actively erupting on the planet. This list of eruptions includes the Shivlech volcano in Russia, which suffered a major flame collapse in 1964, causing 1.5 cubic kilometers of rock to slide up to 16 kilometers distant. The volcano is considered the most reliably explosive volcano on the planet, as in the last 10,000 years it has produced 17 VEI-5 eruptions and 23 VEI-4 eruptions. Another erupting volcano is Masaya in Nicaragua, which is just southeast of the nation's capital. It consists of a complex shield volcano situated in a caldera which formed in three powerful eruptions between 1900 and 6100 years ago. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Guatemala, Volcan Fuego produced a paroxysm from March 6th to 8th, resulting in several evacuations and pyroclastic flows. Also, in Japan, the Fukutoku Okanoba volcano, which produced a new island in 2021, just had its latest eruption upgraded in size. The results suggest that this volcano produced the largest explosive eruption on the planet during 2021. Meanwhile, in Papua New Guinea, the Manam volcano produced a powerful volcanic explosion which sent a plume of ash to a height of 15,200 meters or 50,000 feet. And, in Chile, the volcano which produced one of the most powerful eruptions of the 20th century produced a new volcanic earthquake. The volcano I'm referring to is known as Cerro Hudson, which produced a powerful planetary eruption in 1991 which ejected 4.3 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock. This wasn't the only recent planetary eruption of Mount Hudson, as it produced two caldera-forming VEI-6 eruptions in the last 10,000 years. Thus, it is one of the most explosive volcanoes in South America, so a close eye is kept on the volcano whenever something unusual occurs. After several months of normal activity at the volcano, an unexpected volcano tectonic earthquake hit on March 6 at 6:49 p.m. local time. This earthquake was caused by either the movement of magma or water heated by nearby magma. Regardless of which case is correct, this earthquake indicates that the volcano's underlying magma chamber is in the process of refilling. Unless more earthquakes occur, this quake could simply represent an isolated event, and only time will tell. In Papua New Guinea, the Manam volcano is consistently a headache for airline pilots who have to divert flights whenever a large increase in activity occurs. This volcano is in the midst of an 8-year-long VEI-4 eruption, which has consisted of frequent low-level activity interspersed by powerful volcanic explosions. On the afternoon of March 8th, an uptick in activity led to unusually tall lava fountains at the island volcano, which ejected bombs of lava in a several hundred meter radius. It is quite likely that the new lava then began to partially solidify on the magma conduit, causing an immense amount of pressure to build. This pressure finally burst to the surface at about 7:20 p.m. local time, sending a plume of ash to a height of more than 50,000 feet. Pyroclastic flows from this explosion raced across several drainages on the island and a dusting of ash fell. Luckily, no one was injured by this explosion, which was the largest since October 21st of 2021. In Guatemala, Volcan Fuego produced an eruptive sequence which culminated in several evacuations. Beginning on March 5th, a new lava flow erupted out of the volcano and flowed to the southwest. By the next day, eruptive activity had increased, creating a series of Strombolian-style explosions. Several small pyroclastic flows were then generated, traveling more than a kilometer down the same drainage. Beginning at around 9:30 a.m. on March 7th, activity rapidly intensified, leading to increasingly lengthy and frequent pyroclastic flows, which got unreasonably close to several towns, even overflowing the ravine's sides. Part of the towns of Peminche 1 and San Pedro Yopocapa were then evacuated over concern that a repeat of the powerful 2018 eruption might occur. Luckily, activity subsequently declined, causing a sense of relief to the evacuated residents. As a final note, I have some updated news about the eruption of Fukutoku Okanoba, which occurred last summer. Japanese scientists have since declared that the eruption was a VEI-4 eruption, representing the largest in this volcano's history. Much of the explosively erupted material it ejected was pumice, which went on to cause issues to ports as far away as the Philippines. Here is a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. Also, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which could erupt in the near future. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Artifacts Prime, for supporting this channel.